So we know he knows tons of evidence that he had the tomb. Most scholars believe the tomb became empty. Most scholars. The reason is because Joseph of Arimathea put him in the tomb.
Something new Christian.
And it's kind of like somebody working for the CIA saying that they helped somebody. Apart from the CIA, said that the CIA was going to take him out and say, the fact that so now we've got the resurrection. We've got the death, we've got the empty tomb. Jesus can't destroy that. The only way to destroy that argument is this. It's called the end of the gospel. But if we look at somebody dying, no, we can't go through. I'm looking at you.
Obama says, I don't care. All I want is my policy to carry on.
The resurrection. Here's another argument. Women to test
the
testimony.
And England
is going out of the EU.
Women's testimony, they think they're it and they're whatever. This is what they said, they're not worth anything. So even Josephus said that women are not worth anything. So if we were starting a religion in the first century with the Jews, we would not use women. In the Gospels, you find that it was the women who saw Jesus in the tomb. And in the Gospels, they were spread throughout the ancient world, in the religion, all over the ancient world, thousands of times. You cannot explain that from a secular point of view, why women were the centre of the resurrection. I've asked for movies that have never got as satisfactory. Second argument is the vast majority of scholars, I'd say 19 in the world, say 90%. We'll give you this. Not that the disciples were deluded, this is interesting. The scholars say they weren't deluded. Actually, they really, really believed that they were from the dead. No, it doesn't, but here's the point. Well, what the second part said they were from the dead. Here's the bad, right? That he didn't actually die. But the vast majority of scholars acknowledge that they really believed in the resurrection because he studied Judaism. There was Judaism that believed in spirits, they believed in the physical resurrection. So you have to ask yourself, are you hiding the from testimony? Well, that's
a iffy.
Okay, but John was put in boiling oil, boiling oil, boiled alive. Not in the Bible, tradition. Paul was killed, Peter was crucified, James was thrown off, they lived a good life. I don't see any life. So I'm going to believe that word. When the moment started, people repented. Give them a moment. Some of the founders repented, just came to the end of their life. Mohammed, he said he had people with him. Yeah. But there was no one actually there to witness his revelation. Yeah. But when Jesus resurrected, the people who said they've seen him and they died, very good. I'm not saying that's a knockdown argument, I'm just saying just to consider that. Right. Thirdly, Jews worshipped on a Saturday, time immemorial. And yet these Jews changed to a Sunday. How do you explain that from a sexual point of view? Show me how that happens. Very stubborn.
They're very set
in the way. So for them to change, something dramatic was the matter. Right? So there's three arguments about the woman, about the testimony, about the Sabbath. Those are just some of the arguments. The counter arguments would be, well, it doesn't. You know, you can say there's contradiction in the gospel, which carries behavior, and you can say, well, I've read all that, but it's the resurrection. No, but it's evidence. It gives you solid evidence.
No, I feel like the main issue is that what happened so long ago, surely God would be like, at the top of
the mirror. Well, let me ask you something. Would you say you're open minded?
Potato.
Would you say miracles can happen or can't happen? Or would you be open to it?
I personally don't believe in them, but if one was happening, I'd be like, no.
Would you, could you say you'd rule out miracles in category?
I don't know.
Intellectually, do you know all the knowledge in the universe? So you can't possibly say that it's an old god. You can't say.
I can't say it.
It's not logical because you don't know all knowledge. So that means there's a possibility that you've got. And if there's a possibility of God, there is a possibility of miracle.
Right.
So, if you're honest, intellectual honest, you should be open to investigation. Is that fair? Right. There was a guy called David Hume. Do you remember Hume? An atheist philosopher. And he went to investigate miracles in France, 100 years before him. And he had five criteria. He had to be intelligent, educated, honest, and all that. So he went to the five criteria. Investigated these miracles that happened to the Catholics in France. And he said, according to my five criteria, miracles happen. Guess what he said? Even though my five criteria shows that they happen, miracles don't happen because they don't happen. So they can lie. So no matter what evidence he got, he's never going to believe.